At night she sits alone with no lights on. Incense glowing in the dark. On the dusty floor, broken cup, empty bowl. The shades are drawn in her bedroom where she spends her days alone. Back in better times, she shared her love, her dreams. Well, now it's time for us to gather together. You have so much more living to do. Come share your wisdom, your stories with us. We are all here for you. We love you.
I am Dr. Angelina DeCastro. I am the director of the Bellevue Hospital Asian Inpatient Program. As a psychiatrist working in the hospital setting and in private practice for the past 20 years, I have treated many elderly Asian women who have attempted suicide. In the United States, elderly Asian women have the highest suicide rate among all women of this age group. Although they are from different Asian ethnic and socioeconomic backgrounds, yet they share some common stressors that lead them to try to end their lives. Many of these women live alone, away from their families and friends. Oftentimes, they think that they are a burden to others. They are frail, sick, and cannot take care of their families they used to. Many of them suffer from depression but do not seek treatment. Some of them do not recognize the symptoms. Some of them are afraid of being labeled mentally ill. Many of them do not know where and how to get help, especially if they don't speak much English. Asking for help is not always easy in our Asian culture, especially if you are an elderly person. Your children are supposed to understand what you need without asking, but that is not always possible in the United States. As a community, we need to reach out to our seniors, especially those who are isolated and troubled. People who want to die usually feel that there is no more hope and joy in their lives. please offer a kind word and reach out to make sure that an elderly Asian woman is getting the help she needs. You may be saving a life.
Oh, it's touching, right? Anybody quiet? Not yet, right? Yeah, it's okay. But you see that? That's why we invite you to be here today for our Asian Health and Social Service Councils. This is our monthly meeting in November. And it is the time for us to act together. It is the time for us to try our best to prevent the elderly Asian women from attempting suicide. It is the time, it's time up, to introduce our Peter Yi to have an opening remark. Mr. Peter Yi is the Assistant Executive Director of Hamilton Medicine House. It is well known for the Asian community, and he is overseeing the behavioral health services. And he is also the president of the Coalition, New York Coalition for Asian American Mental Health. Mr. Peter Yi.
Oh, thanks everyone for coming. You guys are all brothers and sisters of the Coalition, Federation, and the Council now. So this initiative basically was brought about a couple years ago by years of hard work of advocacy, and finally this New York State of Mental Health have given us a community some resources to have a awareness campaign targeting elderly Asian women. The money was given to several groups, and we decided to work together, and this is one of the products of this resource and our effort. You will hear in the next 2 hours from many experts, different points of view about suicide prevention. Some of our colleagues have been working on suicide prevention all their lives, some more recently. They will give you some insight into the problem and some strategy how to really combat suicide. There will be a lot of resources in the back. One of the, I will mention is a video called Healing the Spirit, which is a 22-minute video from the West Coast. Is a training video and also resource video about depression among Asian. It's in 8 different languages. Accompanying it will be some training material. This is a series of workshops and events that we'll be holding for the last 6 months and ongoing to until middle of next year. It's a complex issue. It's an issue that touches all our lives. I'm sure every one of us knows someone who have taken their own lives, and elderly Asian women is a particularly high-risk group. So without further ado, I will give you back, John.
Thank you, Peter. And the next one, I would like to invite Ms. Joyce Moy to have our welcome remark. Mr. Joyce Moy is the Executive Director of the Asian American Asian Research Institute of CUNY here. That's why you're sitting here, and we got her support. And actually, she is the first Asian American Director of New York.